Welcome, our dear viewer, once again to another fresh episode on the Bible Journey. That's your show. And today we have a very, very hot subject, but we want to pray for the presence of God to guide us in this discussion. And I know it's of crucial importance to you, and I know that you also enjoy as we discuss, and you have something to also say on the same. Now, on the set with me today are my panelists, as usual. And we have first our resident pastor, Pastor Kabira Wakabira, and there is also John, but I don't know, I like Kabira Wakabira. Welcome, Pastor.
Thank you.
And next to him is our brother once again, Alan Kibet. He has been here severally, and again he's here to share with us and help us more in discussing this particular topic. Alan Kibet, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Next to him, at the middle here, is our dear beloved sister, Sister Pollyann Muthoni. She is here once again to help us discuss on this particular topic. Welcome.
Thank you. I'm glad to be here.
Thank you. And next to me, he has been here severally. Once again, he's back to help us in discussing this topic. He's called Elder Victor Oruko. Welcome.
Thank you.
And of course, I'm Nixon Ratemo. And our topic for discussion today is culture, diversity, and unity. Culture, diversity, and unity. A very hot subject, but I know that you also need it to be discussed. You also have an input. Remember, you can get to communicate with us on our social media platforms, on our Facebook page, Hope Channel Kenya, on our Twitter handle at Hope_Kenya. You can also follow me as well on my personal Twitter account at Nick Ratemo. And I want us to be very positive about this topic. It's something that has been going on for years, and people are still talking about this same issue. We can't avoid but to talk about it. But now, what does the Bible say about this particular topic? What does the Bible say about our tribes? What does it say about our cultures? What does it say about the diversity that we have? And what does it say about unity? Kenya is a land that has more than 42, and actually the president, President Uhuru Kenyatta, declared a 43rd tribe, Makonde community. Is there any wrong with us belonging in a particular tribe? Is there anything wrong with you being a Kikuyu, a Luo, a Kalenjin, a Dorobo, whatever tribe that you belong in? What does the Bible say about that? I don't know, we'll be getting to understand that more. Tell us what you think, ask your question on those social media platforms. Now, as we get into our discussion, let me start with our next to me here to just guide us in a short prayer, Victor.
Let us pray. Gracious Master in heaven, we thank you because of this time, and we thank you for the opportunity that you've given us to discuss with our viewers. Even as we seek to understand our unity in diversity, we pray that the Spirit to be there to lead us, and that you guide your people to know you more and realize that they are one people. For this we plead in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now, let me just start it this simple. I know we have a fear. When you talk about which tribe do you come from, you start asking a person from which community, what's your name? They say, I'm John. You want to follow it with a question, John who? You know, that one brings in the question, what is your intention in asking John who? Why do you want to know my other name? Because, you know, it now identifies us, and it says, oh, he's a Kisi, she's a Kikuyu kumbe. You know, we fear that as a country because of what we have seen happen in our country. But today I want us to be very positive about it and speak it from a positive angle. And let me just ask each and every one of us, just mention briefly, which community do you come from? Which tribe in particular? And do you have any apologies for that?
I am from Meru community, ideally called Tharaka Nithi, but I also count myself as a Kikuyu, mm-hmm. because I'm married to a Kikuyu. You know, I cannot just say I am this and then forget my wife, yeah. who we are one.
Wow, thank you. Any apologies?
I would have to apologize for a lot of things if I apologized about my community, because I have no control over my height, I have no control over my color, I have no control. There are lots of things that I really, I don't know if I will ever change, I will ever do. So you just can't apologize over I am this and that. Sorry if it hurts somebody. Sorry if we are, what? We are the ones who do something that somebody doesn't like. Because it is not me. That's just a stereotype. So nothing to apologize, nothing to talk about. I'm just embracing it. What is good, what is bad, I discard. That's what I do.
Wow. Thank you. Alan.
I'm from the Kalenjin community, particularly an outcast of Kipsigis and Nandi sub-tribes. I have no apologies for that. I'm actually proud to be associated with them, but I'm also proud to be associated with all the rest of the tribes in Kenya and the world over.
Wow. Thank you. Sister Polian.
Well, I am a Mugikuyu, and I definitely make no apologies because God did not make a mistake.
Wow, okay. Victor.
I'm a Luo. I have no apologies to make, because if I am to make apology, I would make apology starting with my color, because this affects me. And all other things. But a good thing I would appreciate, but a bad thing I would definitely discard, just as Pastor said.
Wow. You know, okay, let me start from our country, Kenya. Kenya, 43 tribes. And you know, Sheng, they are saying that Sheng is also like another tribe, so maybe we have 44. And there are some others, like in the northern part of this country, we have a tribe, the name has just escaped my mind, but we met them last year. And we didn't imagine that there was such a tribe in this country, and they even say it's like they are not in Kenya because they are forgotten, they are mentioned nowhere. So we have actually the ones that are known, 43, but there are others that are not known. Did God make a mistake, Pastor, in just creating us all these tribes? Was there any mistake in
that? I will begin by saying, first and foremost, it's good to appreciate what you can change. That's what I said. And the Bible gives a little bit of origin of languages, in which tribes now and cultures are based on languages. And we have to agree first and foremost that tribes are a product of sin. I'll put it like that.
So God, originally, how did God create us?
So God created Adam and Eve.
Adam and Eve. Which tribe was that?
This was supposed to be God's own children.
Were they not
ideally
Jews?
It's not about Jews. Jews came much after. They are also a tribe.
2,000 years later.
Adam and Eve, God said, let us make man in our own image. So he did not say, this tribe, this culture, let me even broaden it, this nation. We are very particular.
Continent.
Or this continent, we're very particular. Of course, ideally, we come much to see later, Adam and Eve and their children, and we see the product of sin, Cain, separating to go and form people who are unruly, and then Seth beginning another lineage that was also good, and then thereafter after we see the family that is brought about by, as a result of Cain, Nimrod building a tower, and then God confusing the languages. It had begun earlier when Noah, he got three children, and out of these three children, they were of different shades, they were of different colors, they went to migrate to different places. So the whole idea, as you can see, is sin separating us from God, separating us from one another, making us divided. And up to today, that's what now we are seeing. That's why, instead of us being proud, we look like we have a problem with... we still have a problem with tribes. We can't even here in Kenya, we can't speak of tribes directly. We don't want to talk about it because truly it's a product of sin, but you just can't do much about it. You can only appreciate, take something positively. So God's ideal was we are one. Mm-hmm. Ephesians 4, verse 4, 5, and 6. Mm-hmm. Ideally yeah. says we are one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in you all. Basically, we are supposed to have one thing. All of us are supposed to be one. Everything one. It's only that because of sin, as you can see, tribes came as a result of sin. They also now, because of the same sin, now we are dividing. Mm-hmm. That's why we are saying, I am this, I am that, I am this, I am that. You know, as soon as you say I, you're already now becoming the selfish part. Mm-hmm. I am this, I am that. You are now retreating back to a safer place, which of course leads to sin. But if I say the first thing is, I am a Christian, I am a child of God, that will give glory to God. But I am this, meaning you identify with a certain tribe, a certain culture, that to you you think is better. Then somebody else thinks it's better, and then it brings more problems. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. That is what is really happening after all this drama we were seeing on results of sin.
Yeah, I would need maybe Pollyanne to add something on that. You know, God created Adam and Eve. There was no issue of tribe. They were just the children of God. Mm. Then when I look at myself, I'm a product of Adam and Eve. So I'm fundamentally their children. And you and I belong to the same father and mother. Mm. So we are like, I'm your brother, you're my sister. Then going back again, we have God who is our father. What would you say there?
It's hard to come behind that because he pretty much put all of it in a capsule. But as he was speaking from, you know, when God created everything, there wasn't a sameness about it. Creation, there was water, there was earth, there was sea, there was diversity. He's a God of diversity. So I can only speculate and think Adam and Eve probably could speak speculation. I have not read it anywhere. You know, multiple languages. And what happened in the Tower of Babel, Genesis 11, mm-hmm. was languages, and he said, you know, it's as a result of sin. But I read a quote once that said, when destruction is the cause of unity, or is the motive behind that unity, mm-hmm. then, you know, and that's why God had to do what he did, because that their motive for that unity that they had was to bring down God, you know, from Lucifer's point of view. But he created or allowed them to have confusion of language, not so much so that this tribe, these people speak, I don't even know if there were tribes, there were languages. If this language is superior to this language, I think that was just a development of the outworking of sin. Mm-hmm. So I believe when God created us as we, you know, we being his children, he meant for the diversity, but not as a form of divisiveness, but for the beauty that it is to come out. Right. So yes, he's our parent. That is what we have as a union, our common denominator. Mm-hmm. But there's also beauty in these different things that he has allowed to see. Yes, it was a result of sin, but we can't use it, we can't hide behind it and say, well, we'll just continue in sin because God made it in the first place. So
let's look at it from a positive
light, which, like I said, if the, your unity, destruction was the motive behind that unity, then...
Well, I want you to explain to us something about celebrating this diversity, but just for the purposes of the viewer, to understand, we are talking about when you talk about the many languages coming about as a result of sin. We have Genesis chapter 11, where when we were still one, human beings were still one, speaking one language, and they decided to build a Tower of Babel, and you know, all these scientific innovations that we have, and improvements, development, and other things. Then God saw that these people are really united to do evil, such that he said, let's go down and see what they are doing. And then when he came and said, I'll just read verse, maybe from verse 6, it says, and the Lord God and the Lord said, behold, the people is one, and they have all one language, and this they begin to do, and now nothing will be restrained from them which they have imagined to do. Verse 7, go to, let us go down and there confound their language, mix up their language, that is, that they may not understand one another's speech. So the Lord scattered them abroad from thence upon the face of all the earth, and they left off to build the city. So when we mention about God mixing up the languages, that is what we are alluding to, which actually comes, you know, chapter 11 comes way after chapter 2, you know, the sinless world. Now chapter 3 is where now we have the sinful world. So languages come in later at that. But now, Victor Ruko, how do we achieve this? You know, she's talking about richness in diversity, and I'm just asking myself, how do we achieve this? How do we celebrate our diversity? How do we achieve this richness?
Thank you. First, I would like to concur with my fellow panelists that the intention of God has been unity, and division of me thinking. Myself thinking that I'm superior than others, mm-hmm. is actually a perspective of Lucifer. If you trace it back even back to heaven, mm-hmm. there was unity until Lucifer decided to rebel.
Yeah.
And throughout the Bible, God desires that we always be one people, much as I may be different, but then we are one people. Now, how would we celebrate our diversity? First, if you look at even the broader perspective, in a nation, we usually talk of international relations, mm-hmm. and there is Ministry of Foreign Affairs. In other words, we are interested in other countries. Now, if we are interested in other countries, it means that we should even be more interested in our own country. Yeah, and practically. Personally, I am a Luo,
mm-hmm.
and my area, we don't grow the Waru, Irish potatoes.
Sure.
Yeah, and it is a very sweet meal. I would not even know about the meal were it not the Kikuyus who produce it.
Mm-hmm.
We do sweet potatoes and not the Warus. In other words, if we can realize that for the society to be complete, then I need a Kikuyu, I need a Meru, and I need Kambas for us to be a complete nation. Actually, a nation is called a nation because of us having different people.
Yeah. Well,
yeah.
Well.
So if we would appreciate that, then definitely we will be one people.
Yeah, and you know, you're talking about what other people can do, what we don't do.
Exactly.
Because you realize that in the Kenyan community, like just mentioned, like Kikuyu. Kikuyus are known to be very good business people. How would a nation thrive without business? It would be very hard. Okay, others do business, of course, but who are doing it? You know, it's like ingrained in them. Mm-hmm. They are very good at it. Look at Kalenjins. If were it not for the Kalenjin community, where would we be as Kenya at the international level? Were it not for the people from the Wakina Kipchoge Keino and the others that make us very proud at the athletics, Olympics, and other games out there, we would be very low as a country. So we are essentially saying that all of us are very important, yeah? And for example, talk about nutrition. How do you survive on fish and sweet potatoes alone and something like magira? I really like it. But you would need other things from other community, like you're saying. Alan,
mm-hmm.
just put a word across, and you know, looking at me, if you cut my hand today, something would ooze out. If I cut yours, something would ooze out. They are all the same. And the Bible talks about that also.
Yeah, the Bible talks about that, the book of Acts chapter 17, mm-hmm. verse 26, if you would read.
17:26 says,
yeah.
And hath made of one blood all nations of men for to dwell on all the face of the earth, and hath determined the times before appointed and the bounds of their habitation.
Yeah, the Bible is saying we are of one blood. If you cut my hand, it's blood, that the same blood that will come out is the same blood that will come out from yours.
You can't differentiate pastors. This yeah. is from a Kikuyu, yeah. this is from a Kalenjin, this is from a Dorobo. You no. can't really tell.
No, you can't.
It's the same.
Yeah, and I would also extend and say that the same pain I would feel is the same pain the Kikuyu would feel. It's the same pain my fellow Meru here will feel, the same pain the Luo will feel. So all in all, first of all, we are human beings. And what affects us as a people, as a whole, affects everyone. Not just my tribe, not just his tribe, not just her tribe. It affects all of us. So the blood that flows in us is blood that was made by God and put in every human being.
I don't know. Mm-hmm. It's not like I like being controversial or something. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Sometimes this pride, you know, I'm proud to be this, I'm proud to be that. I always see it as a problem, which leads to stereotyping.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And it is. Sure.
And as much as we celebrate, we agree. There is a way we need to agree on what is positive and what are we celebrating. Mm-hmm. Are we celebrating what we Merus do, or are we celebrating who Merus are? You know, I say that because sometimes the population sample may be smaller, or let me give an example of we always assume that Kalenjins what are the best runners, which is true because mm-hmm. we know the names. But you know, at the same time we had Samuel Wanjiru, mm-hmm. at the same time we have Rudisha, who is not a Kalenjin, is a Maasai. You know, it's in our thoughts that we think, but ideally somebody else can produce the same thing. Mm-hmm. When we think of Kikuyus as business people, even the richest person probably, officially anyway, in Kenya is a Muhindi, something mm-hmm. like that. Mm-hmm. You know, we tend to stereotype, and that is the only problem I have.
Mm-hmm. And by the way, you mentioned Muhindi, and I remember that we have not mentioned that Hindus are part of this nation.
Yes, and they are Kenyans, absolutely.
They are Kenyans.
And we even have Somali people who are Kenyans. Somali, I live next to them. I live next to Somalis and Hindus.
Yeah,
and they are as proud of Kenya mm-hmm. as I am. Mm-hmm. But sometimes when I meet them, I feel like I am the original Kenyan. They are not original Kenyans. Mm-hmm. What I'm looking at is everybody is proud. Everybody is proud, but what we need to do as a church, what we need to do as Christians is, what are we proud of? How do we use these differences? As she said, it will be boring to build a wall that is uniform. That's why we have, you know, you see how the stones are arranged. They're also not arranged on a straight line.
Yeah.
One, then next, you know, it's like a zigzag.
Mm-hmm.
Why? That way they are much more stronger. But if it was one, there will be issues. I like a scenario in the Bible. Allow me just to read
mm-hmm.
from the book of John 12.
John 12.
John chapter 12, verse 21. Now, verse 20 and 21.
Mm-hmm.
It's about tribalism. It's people about falling back into. You know, we like it, especially here in Kenya. We do it. Now there were certain Greeks among those who came to worship at the feast. People have come to worship, but they also identifying themselves as we are Greeks. You know, they're not coming as worshippers, all of them. They are coming as Greeks.
Mm-hmm.
Then at the same time, then they came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida, of Galilee. That is, they came to Philip, who was a Greek like them. And they asked him, saying, "Sir, we wish to see Jesus." Does that tell you like how we normally visit our offices? You know, I go to a certain office because that's our man.
Mm-hmm.
So we also go visit him. And then the same man, Philip, came and told Andrew. And in turn, Andrew and Philip told Jesus. What is happening is like we know each other. Mm-hmm. So let's go. We are talking about Jesus' disciples who are also affected the same way. With us, with like, I don't know, tribalism or...
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That they felt because they have an advantage, that the Greeks came, they didn't even approach Judas, they didn't approach Peter, they didn't approach John. They want to approach somebody who is Uyuniwetu.
Yeah.
Are they using it the right way? You know, we will say probably Philip and Andrew should be proud, like, these are our people, let me do something for them. And they did, that's what they did. When they went to talk to Jesus, instead of Jesus answering, he says, "This is not time for all this. the Son of Man must be glorified. Look at what Christ has done. He acknowledged, he did not dismiss them that don't bring your tribalism here. But at the same time, he says, this is not that time to dwell on tribalism. It's time to dwell on the glory of Jesus Christ, which I believe is the problem with us Christians. As much as I appreciate diversity, as much as I appreciate tribalism, we still have a problem with what we are proud of. We are proud of stereotypes. We are not proud of being human beings where we are born. So much that we have people who want to change their color, people who want to bleach themselves. Because from the way we're saying, I am proud of, I am proud of, I am proud of, people here, I am proud of a being a Kikuyu because I'm a business person. So where we are poor, what do we think? I wish I was born there. That's why we are poor. You know, what you're proud of has caused somebody else to think I'm marginalized. Same way we talk about, the tribe you're talking about, Pastor Okindo was preaching up there.
Yeah.
There is a tribe that is...
That's Natch community.
I met them and they were saying, I wish I was born where you were born. And I'm thinking, what do you mean? And they say, at least where you were born, you people are proud of. We are proud of where I come from is the Meru that produces a lot of food. So in the end, we are talking about, I'm proud of something that is viewed higher than somebody else.
Yeah.
And which is the problem I have, especially as me as a pastor. Such that now we are zoning ourselves. We are now zoning. If you want to run, you better go to where Kina Kibet comes from. But ideally, this is a talent that God has given. You can run from the law. I don't know if it's scientifically possible. You can be able to do it. You can be a business person. You can. You don't have even to fish nowadays in the lake. You do your own fish pond. Why? Because we instead of embracing the diversity as interdependence, we are now embracing it as a means of standing out. Now, the problem is we are trying to stand out. Every community wants something that they stand out instead of, what do I call it now? What's I'm missing? Interdependence.
And Polian, I know you go out to preach. Pastor does it quite often. That's his job, actually, his occupation. But you also go out to reach out to other people. Even as you add to this discussion, include this. If I were to hate this other tribe, would I really be able to reach them and bring souls to Christ from that community? Because, you know, Christ died for all of us, I guess. He didn't die for the Jews only. He died for all the tribes in the world. He died for humanity. So he needs Kikuyus in that kingdom. He needs Luos. He needs the Kambas. He needs the Giriama. He needs every kind of person from every tribe, nation, and tongue, like he mentions in Revelation chapter 14, verse 6. So would you be able to reach a person from that community that you hate if you were to hate people?
Unfortunately, no, you wouldn't, because that's already a barrier. You would not be an effective tool or vessel for God to use. You're already going with prejudice. And I could turn that around and say the community where you're going to may not, they're like, oh, we only, you know, they have nothing.
They don't
want to listen to you. And I mean, even from Jesus' days, when he was trying to go somewhere, they say their prophet has no honor in their own country. So it is a sin problem, not necessarily because you speak a language that I don't understand. And what actually makes the stereotyping is how the cultures are taught. The traditions, you know, because if it's just differences in language, that wouldn't be,
a
big problem. But you know, I'm saying, well, you're a Mugikuyu and you're supposed to, this is what we, those people are like this. So it really goes back to, especially homes, you know, people with families and what have you, what you instill in your children. If you're wanting them to be effective missionaries, you know, they start with the immediate neighbor who is Luya or who is, a Pokot or whatever, and I shouldn't be put in a box. Excuse me, I'm sorry. I shouldn't be put in a box if I want to name my child Adhiambo. What does Adhiambo mean? What does it mean?
born in the evening.
Yeah, it just means born. There's nothing specific about it. Mm. Born in the evening. So if my child was born in the evening, I can call her Adhiambo. You know, with no problem. It doesn't mean, you know, I should be able to do that without, why are you calling that? It hasn't changed the child. Mm-hmm. You know, so if I'm to be received somewhere or them to receive me, I have to stop perpetuating inferiority or superiority complex. We are humans. Let me take what's beautiful from them, you know, and incorporate that, and we share, and we'll all be one. And that way, the end will come because we can spread this gospel without those barriers.
Maybe just hold on to your point. After this break, you'll be the first one to start.
Okay.
And what I'm getting from this discussion from my panelists here is that we should get out of our cocoons. We are going to discuss much more about this topic. Culture, diversity, and unity. We are together. We are one nation. And we are coming back shortly to continue. Remember to get us on our social media platforms. We are coming back shortly. Welcome back, our dear viewer, to the Bible Journey. And today we are talking about a very crucial subject in this, our country, Kenya: culture, diversity, and unity. And go on with the discussion also on our social media platforms. Facebook, our Facebook page is Hope Channel Kenya, and on Twitter, our Twitter handle is @Hope_Kenya. Also, my personal Twitter handle is @NickRatemo. Now, you wanted to bring in something to contribute on that.
Yes, I just wanted to concur with my panelists by saying that the bit of us being proud of where we come from has been brought negatively. Just this example, for quite a period, people from my community have been known to be good in books, and by God's grace they were leading. Mm-hmm. No. So by us achieving that, we think that other people cannot make it.
Mm-hmm.
And for example, if we speak good English, Pastor is here, who is a Meru and speaks very good English.
Sure,
if I speak good English, then I think that is our thing.
Mm-hmm.
And I start being proud negatively. Now, if we would appreciate our diversity. For instance, if I'm going to preach in Kikuyu land, which I have done, then I want to eat the very, very food that I eat when I'm at home.
Mm.
If I'm given rice mixed with the Irish potato, and then I start despising it. What's this?
You're given githeri.
Yes,
you
I'm given githeri.
This is not food. I'm waiting for food.
Yeah. If a Kikuyu goes to lowland, then he will walk with the nose closed, that fish is smelling bad. Yeah, if we are going to discard that and realize that actually there is beauty in us being different, that I won't know that Irish potato is so sweet if the Kikuyus didn't make me to be aware.
Wow, wow.
That Kikuyus would not realize that fish is a very good meal for them, for those who take,
by the way, it's very good, it's a good meal.
Mm. If it were not lost, then we would actually be proud to be one people and be proud to be citizens of this country.
Pastor, you as we are reading 17 verse 26 of Acts, it said that and hath made of one blood all nations of men for to dwell on all the face of the earth. Then the other segment talks about, and hath determined the times before appointed, that is from creation and even way before, and the bounds of their habitation. Does it mean that God intended that this particular community should live in this area, and this is the boundary? Then the Ameru would start from this particular area. Then after that, we would have the Kalenjins beginning from that area. Was that there anything like that? from this text?
In this text, of course, we know it's 4,000 years later from the drama that was happening.
Mm-hmm.
Its origins are based on the book of Genesis, chapter 10 and 11, where it says, and the people scattered mm-hmm. to the various places to form nations. That is what the Bible says, the last verse of chapter 10. And then chapter 11 also ends, verse 9 also ends with the same, that nations were able to scatter. Ideally, we will understand that if people speak the same language, they should be together, because it's easy. They are able to understand one another. The problem was creating of boundaries. That uwezi pita huku kwetu. And it's very important for us to talk about this because we're getting to the election here in Kenya.
Sure.
And people are even creating imaginary boundaries. During the 2007, they even had erected physical boundaries. That let's see your ID, where are you passing, where are you going? And that was what was evil all along. That we together, yes, we can talk together. Mm-hmm. But are these boundaries? We are together because we are conversing because we are talking in English.
Mm-hmm.
If somebody didn't understand English, probably will be quiet.
Sure.
That's when even the Bible says, if somebody doesn't understand the language you're talking about, then they need to be interpreted. But if they don't understand, just keep quiet. That is why people are together.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, as I'm saying, is the problem is you're taking what is positive and ensuring it's as negative as possible. We now have boundaries, physical ones, even including our neighboring countries. You just can't walk to Tanzania,
mm-hmm.
despite there are Maasai's being in Kenya and Maasai's being in what? Mm-hmm. Similarly, even the Luos who are in Uganda and Kenya, you just can't cross. That human beings are busy erecting barriers to ensure that we, in this election here, you live in here, people. I heard on radio another day, it was just disheartening, that somebody says, I vote as long as it's not the other person. That anybody else, I will vote, but it's not, that their hatred is so deep that anybody else, I don't care.
Mm-hmm.
That he says,
a crook.
He was just told by his mother. He just said he was told by his mother, wewe chukua kura. Mano sipo chukua kura, the other guy will come into power and you'll be in trouble. So he just took, not for his own reasons, but as long as, you know, the hatred is so much ingrained
mm-hmm.
in us that the first thing that comes is negativity. When you read this verse, the first thought is negativity.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas she was saying, it's supposed to be diversity, you know, like it's nice. Go see where there is a lake. Go see where there is an ocean. Go see where there is a mountain. Go see, you know, we are scattered around this place. But all of a sudden, what does God do? When God gives us a natural, nice flora and fauna, what do? We spoil it by saying, here the mountain is us.
Mm-hmm.
And then here is us, here is us. Where we don't agree, like you people on the neighbor, you will always fighting because you want to move the barrier here, move the barrier here. This is ours, this is not yours.
Mm-hmm.
And that is what has spoiled us.
And I guess at this point, I would like to, you know, give a big shout out to all those politicians and leaders who really try to make sure that this nation remains, you know, one nation, who don't divide this country in terms of our community, that we are being, you know, being we are being undermined by these other people.
Are they there?
Those are the kind of politicians that you need, if at all you have.
Okay.
And if we don't have, we need such kind of people.
Mm-hmm.
And I would say, like you're saying, that we need to look at our leaders, even as we go to elections. I know this is now becoming somehow political all in the leadership arena, that we don't need to look at people in terms of my tribe. We need to look at them in terms of, can they deliver? What can they do?
What are we getting? What are we offering?
What are they getting?
I like how Jesus, sorry for interrupting you, when John chapter 4, the Samaritan woman versus Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
I like how they responded. It was more like an election year. I would call it like that. Chapter 4, John chapter 4, verse 9.
Mm-hmm.
Then the woman of Samaria said to him, how is it that you, being a Jew, ask a drink from me, a Samaritan woman? For Jews have no dealings with Samaritans. It's more like, I was saying, it's almost like what you're saying. There is nothing like hakuna kitu mnatuambia. We the only ones who can lead. There is only who can lead. But I like Jesus' response. He talks of issues. He's now no longer dealing with. We are united. He tells her, we are united here by the gift of God. And who it is who says to you, give me a drink. Mm-hmm. That is, look at how Jesus says, answers that question. He even doesn't bother with, you're saying you are Samaritan, I'm sorry, I was born a Jew. No, he doesn't even go to that. He goes straight to the point. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure that is where the problem is.
Yeah,
we are so much based on you and you. We don't do this, we don't do that. As she was saying, we don't do this. As we don't do this, you know, everybody in their own cocoons, but in the end, we forget there should be something that is uniting us that we are running away from. There mm-hmm. must be an issue, there must be something
yeah,
that
sure,
unites
sure.
us.
And then I'll come to Alan, and you know, I would need you also to bring in something about where does this hatred comes from, because we so much hate each other. We you know, you'll find really? That community A hates community B. Tribe C hates tribe D. Where does this hatred come from?
In fact, I was actually heading there by wanting to first say that diversity should not be divisive.
Mm.
You know, diversity should not mean, okay, because you're different from me, then I will hate you.
Mm-hmm.
Or, which is, you know, where we are going. Diversity, I'm imagining the trees and the flowers and what have you. It should be a beautiful thing, like a puzzle. You know, when you're making a puzzle with all those pieces, when they're still in there, not in the same place, it doesn't look like anything. But the minute you put everything together, it's a beautiful picture. I don't think I've ever seen a puzzle of just gray. It wouldn't even be a puzzle, you know. That's a boring piece of equipment. So that's where I was headed. Like, you know, the problem is a heart problem. Mm-hmm. That's where I'm going. Because even whereas, okay, let's just say we have managed to eradicate every other community, and you're left now this particular community, you still find things within to be divisive about within the same
mm-hmm.
community. I'm thinking of, I had lived somewhere for a period of time, and this community, you know, they hated those people. Then those people kind of disappeared, and now they hated it. They're killing each other. There's more of them killing each other than those out there killing them.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really
it
a heart problem.
Down to our families.
Yeah, yeah. It will trickle down to up to that point, you know, where what your heart. Mm-hmm. Why are you projecting all this evil and negativity? What is the problem? What is the underlying problem?
Mm-hmm.
Which I go back to as saying the I situation, self survival. I'm trying to survive.
Mm-hmm.
So first it looks like I want us to survive. Then when we have survived, I'm still going to find something
mm-hmm.
to cause problems.
Mm.
So that's
well,
what
well, well, and maybe as you add on that, you know, there's the issue of politics. I mentioned about politicians and leaders. You know, politics has its way of operating and making sure that it achieves its own agenda. And I've seen that in our country since you know, long time ago, but now it became more obvious in the 2006, 2007, 2008 there up to now. Where politics or politicians are the ones who are really dividing us as Kenyans. Maybe you should, Alan, bring in something on politics and opinions that we have as a country and leaders.
I would say that I've been affected in a way or another.
Mm-hmm.
All of us have been affected. And the truth of the matter is, like she put it, even if we eradicate every tribe and remain with our own tribe only
in Kenya,
we'll still have problems.
You still fight Kipsigis versus Tugen.
Yeah, versus Nandi versus.
Nandi. Then after you're done with the other and you're remaining only Kipsigis.
Yeah, we'll still come back to maybe our clan.
Mm-hmm.
We'll still come back to maybe my family.
Yeah.
You see, even in families, we still have problems. Brothers are killing each other.
Sure.
Sisters. Father, mother, children, even in families.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not an issue of it's that tribe that has a problem.
No.
It's our hearts that have problems.
Mm.
You see, God in his own wisdom decided that I will create tribes. He decided that because he had given a command that multiply and fill the earth.
Mm-hmm.
But then when these people came out of the ark, they thought, well, there may be a destruction coming up. Let's build something that will ensure that when this destruction comes,
we survive.
Mm-hmm. So they gathered in one place.
They were creating a solution for the what happened in Noah's time.
Yeah, and so they were thinking God was wrong in saying we go all over. And so God decided, Apana, you still need to go all over. And so he created the tribes. And his main purpose in that was that man may spread his love all over the world.
Yeah.
And when that point came, he saw that even that purpose was not being fulfilled in the tribes.
Mm-hmm.
He chose the nation of Israel. He gave them very many advantages and very many favors.
Mm-hmm.
But his main purpose in choosing them was that they may spread his love to the rest.
And be an example,
and be an
spread it far and beyond.
Yeah, but then these Israelites took it. The pride issue came in.
Mm-hmm.
We are the children of Abraham.
Yeah, yeah.
We are the chosen nation.
Mm-hmm.
It's us. Yeah.
It's us who belong to God. It's not you.
Yeah.
You are an outcast.
Yeah.
Yeah. And Victor wants to add something. And even as you add, maybe you should also tell us something about, there is the issue of, there's a greater picture than what we are seeing here. There's a greater thing happening, more than us fighting against each other, more than me fighting you because we belong to different communities. There's something bigger than that we should look at.
Yeah, thank you. One thing that we should not forget, if you read from the book of Luke chapter 3, the chapter gives the genealogy of Christ, and Christ is traced from Adam, and he is traced even from God. Adam, who was the son of God. In other words, we all generate from one single family.
Mm-hmm.
What I usually say is this, that the issue of disunity perpetuated by politicians is actually a thing of the devil, because he knows. Or the politicians who are used by the devil, unfortunate to say, they know very well that
when they are doing they are dividing.
When they are dividing, they know very well that at that very time that we will be united, such that I start seeing a Kikuyu or a Kamba as my brother, then when I'm voting, I will not vote my person.
No.
I will vote based on a policy, somebody who is able to rule me.
Or maybe you'll vote my person because he's doing what is approved even before God.
Exactly. Yeah. And just as Alan pointed out, division will always be there. Mm-hmm. You know, at national level, we talk of tribes. Then you go back to, like now, my place. When we are voting as a nation, I mean, in the general election, we say this tribe.
Mm-hmm.
When you go back to Nyanza, we say again Central and South Nyanza.
Mm-hmm.
When you come to constituency again, we say this region and this, even in the ward. So it is a division which actually is perpetuated by the devil, because he knows that he is the origin of disunity. And so long as we are not united, in other words, I'll not be interested, even if you are not aware of the second coming of Christ. After all, you are a Kisi. You know, I will feel like we are the people who should even lead the church. Unfortunately, this has come even in the church. You will hear.
We are seeing it in our churches.
In our churches, even during election years, somebody proudly stands and say, please vote wisely. And when I'm saying vote wisely, I'm simply saying that you know the kind of people you should vote for.
That's very pathetic.
Yeah, very, very pathetic. And you will find that even the church is aligned to a certain political party, because they feel like majority of us come from a community that is associated with a certain political party.
Oh,
very, 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 very unfortunate.
Very unfortunate.
The moment we will realize that we need to be one people and be united, that is the time that we will vote on, being vote people based on who can lead me and not my person.
I'm seeing a greater picture than me fighting a Kikuyu or fighting a Luo. I'm seeing a greater picture than that there is a greater war than this, and we are making the devil to triumph, actually. So as you think about your final thoughts in just 30 seconds each.
When Jesus was leaving, of course, the disciples were worried. And so he prayed for them and he said a lot of things. Mm-hmm. Great controversy. What we need to understand is the great controversy, it's not us. Mm-hmm. It's the devil who is fighting God.
Sure.
We're just but the instruments because we show God's love. But unfortunately, we have not learned that aspect. I always ask myself, what do you stand to gain when you bring politics into the world? The same people who voting our people are sometimes the poorest. Really, absolutely. If maybe the current Runda Muthaiga people are voting, they will vote somebody for them who's done something for them. I will concur with them also. Let's also create, because I see most of you are doing well. But you see, the hatred and the sin that is in our minds, that the devil has implanted in us, has obscured us from even reasoning, normal reasoning. Mm. You have a friend, neighbor, mnaanika nguo na yeye, mnachota maji pamoja. Then somebody, somewhere whom you've never seen, you always see on TV, tells you that is your enemy. Mm-hmm. One day you wake up and kill that person. Mm-hmm. It tells you that really you have the devil himself, not even the angels of the devil. Because there is no way that will happen. The great controversy, the devil has lied to us so much that we don't even know what we believe in ourselves.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
That now we have tribes, we have people who will kill for somebody. And they don't even know. When they are taken to court, they say, "I don't know what happened. I don't know. You were many of us." Because indeed, it was not. It was the devil who was in their lives. Absolutely.
Yeah.
And that's why I like how God, God knew we are tribes, and He says, John 17 verse 21 and 22, mm-hmm. when He's praying for all of us, and I love that verse sincerely. I'm sometimes emotional when it comes to these matters because the church is finished. Absolutely. We even zoning our churches. Christ said, 17 verse 21 and 22, mm-hmm. but they all may be one, as you, Father, are in me and in you, that they may also be one in us, that the world may believe that you sent me. Mm-hmm. The world doesn't believe us because we are also divided.
Yeah.
The church itself, we have a church for. This community have a church that they subscribe to, this church and this church. That even when you go to another church, let me say, when you become a Seventh Day Adventist, you are asked, "Unanaka kanisa wale watu?" You know, like, that church is theirs. Mm. We absolutely not divided. And you can imagine Christ's last word was, "Please God, I'm praying that they may be one."
One.
Because He knows what the devil is doing. And we are not learning. Those of us who are here in the studio and those of us who are watching us, the devil is using us to divide us. Mm-hmm.
So how do we make the world believe us and believe the message that we are carrying to them as a church?
As a church.
Mm. Or as Christians.
We have the three angels' message. Revelation 14:6 says, mm-hmm. "Let us go preach into every nation, kindred, tribe." Mm-hmm. That is what this angel is saying, what Christ was saying, mm-hmm. is go and preach.
Yeah.
Without discriminating. Mm-hmm.
And first of all, unite, like Christ is saying.
Yes,
here.
That we may be one. You know, so if I'm preaching one, yeah. if I, you know, the Bible is still one.
Yeah, sure.
Even when it's translated into other languages, it's still the same Bible.
Same Bible.
Same message. But thank how we pastor. Read it and I interpret it differently is what I can't understand.
Let me start with Alan. Just some 10 seconds. Your final thoughts.
Yeah, you see, the verse that he was reading, at the end of it says, what the world must see. Mm. The world will only believe that you are my disciples if they see that we are all one.
Yes, mm-hmm.
If we are united as one. Mm-hmm. I would want to read this verse. Mm-hmm. It says in 1 Peter chapter 2 and verse 9.
Or maybe you just paraphrase.
Yeah, it says, uh-huh. "But ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, an holy nation, a peculiar people, that you should show forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness
into
his marvelous light." Now we've been called out of darkness into marvelous light. Not that we may be proud and start showing the superiority complex we're talking about, but that we may show forth the praises of him who called us out of darkness into his marvelous light.
Wow, thank you. Polian.
John 16:34 says, you know, they will know we are Christians by our love. Mm-hmm. My love for him, you know, regardless of where he comes from. I kill him today, my child will need a kidney, he was a perfect match. Mm-hmm. You know, just destroying. So I'm saying it's, when we're asking for stuff, you know, the medical things, nobody says, from this community, this is where I want this heart from. You know, we're all humans.
You want blood from...
You know, we're all humans. So in destroying one another, we're destroying ourselves.
Wow.
Kenya is a boat. We drill a hole, we're all going down.
Wow. Thank you. Finally.
If you read the book of Romans, chapter 12, verse 4 downwards, Paul is saying that we are united in diversity. And if we are going to embrace this as a nation and realize that we are one people, even if we do what, I will never change my color. I will never cease to be a Kenyan. Even if I get green card, I will never cease to be a Kenyan.
Yeah.
And again, as a church, apart from preaching, it should be seen in us having a practical unity, so that if somebody is leading, then what I do is to support the very person, and not saying that we are not represented in that executive. Mm-hmm. But if even in the church, I still feel like Kisis are not leading well, or we should have the Luos leading, mm-hmm. or Kikuyus are not leading, then that is what is actually taken into the world. And for that reason, we won't be.
How will they listen to us if we keep saying that now it's time for us to rule?
It's our time.
In charge. Yeah. How will the world listen to us when they are seeking our advice? Yeah. Now, what you are essentially saying from the panelists here, what I'm getting is, actually, number one, be proud of who you are.
Mm.
Don't be proud, like he said, just because of maybe some advantages that you have, but be proud of your community. And then let's all be proud of the diversity that we have, because it's because of this diversity that we have the beauty of Kenya as a country. When we have the Kikuyus with us, when you have the Kisis, the Luyas, the Maasais, the Kalenjin, the Robos, the Turkana, and all these tribes, that's what makes us Kenya as a country. Let's be united as a people. Let's cast that which is evil, which is wrong, and let's uphold that which is good. And I'll just request that as we finish, if our national anthem can just play to just tell us that we are a one country. My name is Nixon Ratemo. A brief prayer from our brother Alan.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we are grateful once again for the opportunity to study and hear from you.
Mm.
We thank you for the spirit that has led this discussion, and we pray that even that which we did not touch on, that you want your people to get to know, you may present it to them in the best way possible. It's a humble request in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Remember Facebook, Hope Channel Kenya, Twitter @Hope_Kenya. Keep the discussion going.